live from Hollywood, it's time for the KTLA Morning News at 9 with Michaela Pereira, Jessica Holmes, and Cher Calvin. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Good morning indeed, and may I just say, happy Friday. We're going to call it...
He's best known from his 13 years presiding as judge on the People's Court. Judge Joseph Wapner's legal career spans over half a century. He's now taking his legal expertise to the web in an effort to help both the plaintiffs and defendants alike make sense of the small claims court system.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Judge Wapner. Come on out, Judge. Look at that. Wow, what a pleasure.
Hi, Judge. We give big hugs on the show. We give hugs.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
And I will just be across the room. How are you? What a pleasure. Do you hear that music in your sleep now, Judge?
I do. It's like memories. We hear it again.
It really did. Yeah. And he brought his court documents and everything with him.
Oh, gosh, court documents. Thanks for coming in today, Judge. We're so happy to have you here.
Thank you.
We're going to talk about your book and the web and it being on the web in just a minute. But first, a nice hello and how you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Great. You look fine. You're going to do our dance party at the end of the show, right?
Of course.
Right? He loves to dance. We were chatting earlier. He loves to dance. And little known fact, you don't know about the judge, he dated Lana Turner.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
One date.
That's a relationship in Hollywood these days. One date is a relationship in Hollywood these
and
days.
And also a, whole other story. A USC graduate.
That's correct. Twice.
Twice. Because once wasn't enough.
Law school.
Undergrad and law school. So you're always, do you ever go to the games? Are you a big Trojan supporter?
Not anymore. Not since Rusty died.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're so glad to have you here, sir.
Yeah,
thanks for joining
you.
Us.
Let's start out talking about your web-based project. Tell us about it. Tell us what you have going on here. The secrets to winning in small claims court.
Yes. Judge Wapner's guide to small claims court. The idea is to be prepared when you go to court. Stay out of court if you can.
I like
settle.
That idea.
That's a
I like
great
that
idea, too.
Settle if you can. That's the best way to go.
Yeah. Okay.
But if you can't,
this is the guide
this
you need
to
know.
This is the guide to use.
Very helpful. Well, we'll talk more about that in depth, because I think most of us would like to avoid our day.
We all need to know that. Yes, we do. So we'll talk to you about that in just a second. But first, here's what people are talking about today. Our water cooler buzz. Okay, listen to this. The CEO of AT&T says it's having trouble finding enough skilled workers to fill all 5,000 customer service jobs it promised to return to the U.S. from India, and they promised that back in 2006. Well, so far, only 1,400 jobs have been returned to the U.S., and Randall Stevenson blames the increasing high school dropout rate for lack of skill that is forcing them to outsource. And he thinks the solution should be a stronger focus on education here in the United States. Now, the question is, do you buy this? Is this indicative of our nation's school system, or do you think this is simply a dollars and cents issue? So many people think outsourcing to India is cheaper. That's why the companies are doing it. And it's a lot cheaper. I've looked up the numbers, and we'll talk about that just in just a minute. So,
I was actually really under the impression that it was really all about dollars and cents, the reason they were outsourcing.
Yeah.
Isn't most things. Yeah.
In this day and age, it really is.
Yeah. So. I mean, I think the statement that they're putting out is really just baloney to cover up the fact. I mean, bottom line, this issue brings up a really hot-button topic here in America, and it juxtaposes our patriotism of, you know, providing jobs for people in our country versus capitalism,
right,
which is a foundation of our country also, being able to get the best deal and make the most profit, and that's essentially what they're doing here with their outsourcing.
Mm-hmm. I think you can find enough skilled workers in this country.
Yeah.
We are over 300 million people in this country, and I think you can find 3,600 people that can answer a phone in customer service. Yeah. I think they're out there, and I think they want jobs.
But, Judge, you got to wonder, I mean, there's a lot of criticism of our schools and the education that American kids are getting. Do you think any of that? Do you think there's any merit to what this study is saying?
Well, excuse me. Got a frog in my throat.
Pesky frogs.
Water, please, water.
It is water.
Well, I think the educational system is very sad.
Mm-hmm.
We need to do an awful lot of work to educate our kids.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right.
But right now, too, in the workforce, there are a lot of people who are very educated who are out of jobs, who could use jobs. So.
That's true. Well, it'll be interesting to see, you know, I'm sure there'll be much made of this report and this study.
Right. It's all over the net.
I mean, it is all over the net.
So many people have responded to this on the net, and basically the reaction seems to be, we are out here, we are skilled, you can hire us.
Put us to work.
Yeah, put us to work.
We need the work.
Right. Well, here's somebody who might be needing to be retrained. Have you, you probably heard about this story. The TSA is actually might get sued if a passenger does not get an apology for forcing her to remove her nipple rings. Mandy Hamlin was catching a flight from Lubbock to Dallas, Texas last month when her nipple rings set off a handheld metal detector. Now, she was told, she told the guard that she was wearing this unusual jewelry. A lot of people have piercings these days, earrings, et cetera, et cetera. They're demonstrating it here on the front of the bra because obviously that's kind of the way you do it for TV. It sort of said, look, this is the kind of jewelry, and asked if she could simply just show them to a female security agent. You know, I have a belly button ring, and I will tell them when I'm going through security, I have this ring because I don't know how sensitive
the
machine. Yeah, I do. I'm not going to show it to you now.
That was going to be my
sorry,
next question.
She was denied, and she was told that she had to remove them. So she was taken behind a curtain, and she had difficulty removing one of them because sometimes the skin grows around your piercings,
right,
you know.
Right.
You don't take
them
in and
out all the time. Right.
And she had difficulty. Then she had to ask for pliers.
Ugh,
when
ouch.
She had trouble removing one of them. The TSA is investigating to see if its policies were followed. In fact, she said when she was behind there, she broke into tears because she's in pain, she's uncomfortable, she's embarrassed, and she hears one of the TSA guys snickering in the front. Apparently, you know, the TSA doesn't have...
I smell a lawsuit.
You smell a lawsuit. Well, and this is what I wanted to ask you, Judge.
Right? You would know.
Are we at a real deficit in terms of common sense in this world that people can't just sort of use their own common sense in a situation like this? Is this why we have so much litigation going on in our nation?
Well, as far as common sense is concerned, you're right. But I have to go back to the fact that why was she wearing them in the first place? It's her privilege, I know.
Sure.
It's a free country. But it seems awfully silly to me.
Well, and there are people that sort of say, hey, why bother with piercings? But again, it's a freedom of choice kind
That's
of
right,
situation.
It is.
Not for me.
Now, you'll see Asha and I are ready to go to battle on this one.
Okay, go. Let's go. Go ahead.
Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding.
You can referee judge if you like. Okay, you might have to slap us down or something.
Okay.
Go ahead, Loni. My position on this is, look, we have to go through airport security. We all know the issues that are at stake in our country. If there are rules to follow, follow the rules. If she didn't want to have to take out her nipple rings, you don't have to fly.
Here's my question, though. Is there's no rule that says that you have to, because I'll tell you, my belly button ring has never set off an alarm.
Well, and I think that's what they were trying to say, is it comes down to how much metal was in there, whether her nipple rings were much, you know, heavier, and then that makes it more dangerous. Can there be something hidden in there? We don't know what, you know, possibilities the terrorists are thinking of, and they're the ones who are trained to look at these things like that, and if they felt that that thing was a possible danger and they wanted it out, then they have the right to say that, and she has every right to say, I want to keep it in, and I don't want to fly.
Go,
okay.
Asha.
All right.
Point, counterpoint.
Okay. We live in a country where I think that we can be a little more dignified. I think when we're at the airport and we're asking somebody to use pliers to take something out of their nipple,
yes.
I think we've gone, oh, judge is getting mad at me. Judge is getting mad at me.
And they didn't They didn't ask her to use the pliers. That's what she had to do.
Well, she had to do it. But she would have gone for a pat-down, according to her lawyer, had they offered
Gloria
a pat-down.
By the way.
Had they offered a pat-down, they offered a pat-down, she says her client would have taken it. I think that if we get to the point where you need pliers to take something out of your nipple, we have a problem and we need to do it a better way. I'm not against the security because I'm all for improved airport security, but I think we need to come up with a better way. All right, Judge. Do you agree or disagree?
The prosecutor or the defense? Who do you go with?
That's true. That is true.
Who makes the better argument?
I think the judge is on my side.
I think I'm losing.
I think he agrees that, you know, nipple rings are just one of those extraneous things, and, you know, you're not going to get a lot of protection here. If you can't wear them, you know, you got to take them out.
If I had to make a decision, I'd be with her.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But it's okay,
thank
Asha,
you,
I back you up. The one thing that this conversation does bring about, though, is the need for across-the-board regulation, because it seems to me that each airport you go to has slightly different requests.
That's true,
for you take off your shoes at this one, you have to take off your earrings at that one. It would be nice, as a traveler, for me to know, I just...